object of this exercise is to ensure that Iran's nuclear program will always remain peaceful and to remove all the restrictions that have been imposed on Iran, in our view, unjustifiably.
The inspectors will have access throughout the entire supply chain, going all the way back to uranium production, through centrifuge manufacturing to actually operating facilities.
This is for the first time the most serious interaction at the highest level between Iranians and Americans.
Based on what I know of the deal, if they get the deal they're trying to get, I think it would be far better than not having it.
We have welcomed the nuclear deal.
So you're not against it?
Of course not. What we would like to be sure of is that when we read the fine print, once that deal is signed, hopefully next month, that that fine print will be reassuring to us.
Let's face it, we wouldn't be where we are today with international sanctions, et cetera, if there were not, significant suspicions, shall we say, about earlier activities.
Iran cannot be trusted. I have heard those words about Iranophobia. This is the most justified phobia in the world.
Time and again, people have been predicting for the past 20 years that Iran was a year away from making a bomb, and that prediction has been proven wrong time and again.
Supreme Leader has, I can tell you, given the permission for my government to freely negotiate on these issues.
So you do have that authorization?
Yes.
The Ayatollah is behind the deal, or rather he is inclined, he supports the deal. On the other hand, you must realize that the only important group that wholeheartedly do support the Ayatollah are the hardliners. And all of them have actually risen against the deal.
If the United States doesn't solve this problem with Iran, Iran has no incentive to talk about anything else. This is the most important issue.
No deal is better than a bad deal, but the world will be better off if Iran and the United States can find the agreement that satisfies everybody's test.
The prevailing expert opinion is that if a successful set of military strikes would only delay the onset of a weapon capability for a couple of years, if you can put it off 10 years, the world could turn upside down 15 times in 10 years. And Iran could be a different place, the Middle East could be a different place.
We want to resolve this issue, and we will do our best, provided that our partners are prepared to walk this road with us.